Hey, hot tubbers, how is everyone doing today? Welcome to the stream. We are super excited to have you all here. And as always, guys, jump in and tell me what kind of hot tub you have, whether you have a saltwater or a regular hot tub. And make sure that you let me know if you have an ICare already or not. That'll help us decide which way we're going to go. I have Jim Walz from Ideal Water Care is on here with me today. And we have a lot of questions. Some of people already have them and some that are people that are looking to buy some because we do have a there's been a lot of stuff happen in the smart water monitoring system that has happened lately. So just a little quick stuff to do beforehand. Of course, you guys, everybody always wants to know how they get on to the screen at the beginning, and that's by doing the buy me a coffee. That's not going to work. There it goes. You just go to buy me a coffee and you can actually buy me a coffee and we'll get your name up on this screen by doing that. And then everything that we're talking about today, there's going to be a link down in the description. So there's going to be ways to get a hold of Jim. There's going to be ways to buy the ICare. There's going to be ways to register to win an ICare today. And we're going to just answer all your questions down below. So if you have any questions, by all means, check the description in the show notes and it will definitely be there. But here we go, guys. Let's get Jim on here. So, hey, Jim, you are on camera now. So,
welcome. Hello, everybody.
So glad to have you. And hey, guys, if you have any questions for Jim or any questions about your ICare, now is definitely the time to ask them. So jump on board and just say, hey, and let us know what's going on. I'm super excited to see everyone. I hope you guys are all ready for Christmas. It is going to be here, what, Friday? Saturday. Saturday already is Christmas. Is that nuts Saturday. Or what? Are you ready?
I'm not ready. I haven't even started shopping yet.
What? Seriously.
Seriously, I have not.
So when and how are you going to go shopping?
I'm thinking Wednesday, Thursday are going to be pretty good days.
Okay. Well, good for you. Good luck with that. Yeah. That's going to be a challenge for sure. I was actually a little frustrated. I did some grocery shopping at Sam's Club and I was going to pick it up on Tuesday. I just, you know, did the order and pick it up. And my daughter-in-law, who lives in Sioux Falls yet, just got a message saying that they were going to ship it, most of it, to her house. And I'm like, what the heck? I was going to pick it up on Tuesday. So that's super frustrating because she's got to bring the baby up and stuff. And so she's going to be full. So, okay. So let's just jump into it. Let's talk about the amazing ICare. Tell me what it is. Tell me what it does. Tell me why I should have one.
Okay. So the ICare is a water monitoring device. And really, when you look at the bigger picture of how to have great water, it all starts with monitoring your water so you know exactly what's going on with your water to have the best experience in your hot tub. The ICare does work on both hot tubs or on hot tubs, swim spas, and pools. But today we are going to be talking about specifically hot tubs. So the very first thing in having great water is being able to monitor that water. And ICare is a great solution for that, and we'll go into the details of why. The second thing is having a good sanitizer that's in the water. Having the water sanitized on a regular basis makes, again, that hot tub enjoyment much better. The third thing to have great water is making sure that your water is balanced. And then fourthly is just making sure that before you drain it, you go through the proper steps. So when you do refill it, you're starting off with the best and cleanest hot tub possible to kind of get started. So going back to the monitoring of the ICare literally will test the water every hour for you. It will analyze exactly what's going on with that water. And the neat thing that a lot of people love about it is the fact that it doesn't give you a knee-jerk reaction. A lot of times when you're using other forms of testing, it's 1 second in time, it's a very small amount of water, and then you try to make a counter adjustment just based off that 1 second in time. Whereas ICare, testing the water every hour 24/7, it gives you an overall better idea of how your water is actually sitting. So again, it'll test it every hour, it'll go analyze it, then it will turn around and give a solution to it based on, and we'll go into as far as everything that it does test, but it will go through each one of those tests and say, okay, now this is what we're going to recommend. And then the fourth thing is this has AI software similar to Nest. So a lot of other water monitoring devices out there require you to go enter in all of these different chemicals, and they want to know the brands, the amounts, the quantities, everything. With ICare, you don't have to do that. It will literally learn the effectiveness of the products you're adding to the water and then turn around and readjust. So let's say the first time it said to go add 2 ounces of pH down. Well, based on the quality of where you're getting your products, maybe you're getting higher quality products, and the next time it's going to say go add 1 ounce of pH down. But if you go get stuff that's not as good and it's got a lot of junk in it, all of a sudden it's going to say go add 3 ounces of pH down. And the value of that is, one, saving you money in your water care products. But number two is you're minimizing the TDS, which is total dissolved solids, in that water. And when you can minimize the total dissolved solids, you're having to drain it less often, reheat it less often, and your water is that much easier. So less is more, and ICare allows you to add less when you're buying those better quality products.
And
so that kind of gives you an idea of the overview.
In that ICare, you can actually, I believe, can't you change it so you can actually put some brand names in there if you are using some brand name chemicals? Or is that something that's coming yet?
It's still coming. So right now it really has two brands in there. One, it just says generic, where that's where you're just kind of learning it. And then the second one that's in there is Ideal Water Care's Soft Skin Spa, mm-hmm. which is part of that third part of keeping the water balanced. So that is the only other product, brand name product, that's in there. And it will tell you exactly how much to go dose. So what most people struggle with more than anything is, how much do I go add and when do I go add it? ICare tells you exactly when to add it and how much to add. They don't have to think about it anymore. It just does it. And as long as you're looking at your notifications and saying, okay, it told me to go add 1 ounce of chlorine, or it told me to go do this, or it told me to go do that, your water will be perfect because it is testing it and readjusting accordingly.
And that's probably the biggest thing that I notice at the store is a lot of people will bring in, they'll come in with their ICare and they'll come in with their water sample and they'll be like, you know, hey, it's not telling me to do this, what your machine is telling me. And this could have been sitting in your car for 4 days. This is just a very small amount. You could have added chlorine after you brought me this water sample, which happens a lot. You know, people will bring their water sample, they'll make their adjustments, and then they almost consider that a challenge to see if they did the right thing before they actually did it. So I get a lot of people who do that. And there are things, you know, like I'll tell people, I said, did it tell you to change something? If it didn't tell you to change something, it's still thinking, it's still learning, it's still,
exactly.
And you do need to give it a week or two to really get to know your hot tub and do what it needs to do. But it is, you guys, if these are amazing. And, you know, one of the things, I'm going to go there now. The big news in the industry is Finn went out of business. And so Finn was probably your biggest competitor with this product. And but they went out, they're done. I mean, they're just flat out done. There's no way that Finn is going to support you in any way in any time. Now with this product, there is no subscription. So you don't have to, if you do buy this product, you don't have to pay a monthly fee to have it. You don't have to get a subscription to get the chemical sent to you. None of that stuff happens. And so it is absolutely amazing on that. And it tells you exactly what needs to happen. So it is, I mean, I guess, tell me your thoughts. Tell me what that means to this industry now that Finn is no longer there and you have the ICare, and what are people's options?
Yeah, so I mean, even though I would normally compete against Finn on a regular basis, it really is two different categories. Even though they were both or they're no longer, but I'm still in the water monitoring device category. Theirs was really, and there's a lot of them, there's others out there that are disposable products. You know, the fact that Finn and others will have things that you've got to go buy on a every 30 days or every quarter to go replenish it. The reoccurring money that you have to spend with those disposable products is mind-blowing. I mean, they'll give you an initial lower price, but then long-term, you're paying for it. Whereas ICare is, it's not a disposable product. And there's really three main things that separate ICare from everybody else. One is the fact that all of our sensors, and there's three sensors, they're all replaceable and recalibratable. So if you needed to replace it, you simply can take one out, put a new one in, and you're good to go. The second thing is the AI software. The fact that it will learn the effectiveness of the products you're adding. And then thirdly, having a rechargeable battery that the app turns around and tells you exactly what the percentage is. And when it gets down below 20%, it'll tell you the steps to take to go recharge that battery. Now that battery life, this is one of the questions that comes up, is how long does that battery last between chargings? That is dependent on your Wi-Fi signal. So no different than your cell phone. You get into some remote area, you try to make a phone call and your battery drains a lot quicker. ICare isn't any different. Matter of fact, any battery isn't any different. It's all based on that signal strength. So the stronger the Wi-Fi signal strength, the longer that battery is going to last between chargings. And there's people that will get, you know, 2-3 months, and there's some people that will get 6 months out, you know, in between chargings. But again, the app tells you when you get too low, it tells you the steps to take to turn around and recharge it. So the fact that you're buying the device, it's a very robust system. As a matter of fact, it was designed and engineered in Europe. And in Europe, they don't believe in disposable products. And most of the products that are here in the States are designed and developed, and in a lot of cases, unfortunately, built in China. And those are disposable products. They're just, you pay for them and then they last a year or two, and then you got to go buy a new one. The warranty on ICare is also 2 years. And that's in its entirety, whether it's the sensor or the battery, it's guaranteed for 2 years.
And you guys have been fantastic. Absolutely fantastic with any of the warranty issues that we've had. You've been 100%. There hasn't been one situation where I was like, well, you know, that's all we can. You guys have been absolutely fantastic on the warranty situations I've had. I can have zero complaint with that. So there is some peace of mind with that. So I'm going to jump into the comments here real quick, but I love what you're saying. Kayla's on here. She says, what does she say? She says, happy Christmas. She's got the rhythm with an at ease. Frank says, hey, Jim, how's it going? We got Ron here. Ron, welcome. We're glad you're here. He has a question. He says, how does it work with the Frog at ease in the smart chlore system? I've actually had that question quite a few times. So,
yep. As a matter of fact, I was just responding to an email right before we started this. Same question. So the ICare tests the sanitizer based on what's called ORP, which stands for oxidation reduction potential. And it's actually looking at the oxidation of the water. So oxidation happens through the chlorine that is in it at ease. It happens through sodium dichlor, calcium epichloride, tablet-based, bromine-based. Those are all even non-chlorine shock. Those are all oxidizers. So we're looking at the oxidation or oxygen level of the water to determine whether or not we have enough sanitizer in that water. So whether it is at ease or any other oxidation-based product, the ICare is going to be able to test and adjust accordingly for that. The only product that it does not work with is a biguanide, and that's because that's not an oxidation-based sanitizer. That's a very good question, though, but it does work with at ease.
So, and then ORP, you talked about ORP, which is oxidation reduction potential. I mean, where does that come from? Why are you just not using PPM? Why are you using ORP?
So it's a great question. So ORP is actually the commercial way of testing for a sanitizer or lack thereof, but it takes in consideration other elements that the ICare is testing, whereas PPM or parts per million does not. So as an example, this is probably the biggest advantage to ORP versus PPM. ORP is going to turn around and look at the pH of the water and determine whether or not that oxidation is going trending upwards or down or staying even. Whereas parts per million does not take in consideration the pH of the water at all. So when you look at, let's say you're trying to maintain 3 parts per million of chlorine in a hot tub, 3 to 5, and your pH is 7.5, everything is good. But the minute that pH goes to 7.8, you literally have to have 3 times the amount of sanitizer or chlorine in the water to have the same level of effectiveness in that water. Because
people need to hear that.
So if you're trying to maintain 3 to 5 parts per million, pH is 7.5, everything is good. But the minute your pH goes to 7.8, which is very normal for it to happen, you literally have to have 3 times the amount of sanitizer in that water to have the same level of effectiveness, because the higher the pH, all of a sudden it starts reducing your sanitizer's ability to be effective in the water. And PPM doesn't do it. It can't do it. ORP does, and it will look and cross-reference that. Even the temperature of the water will have an effect on that sanitizer is functioning. So if you have your water at 100 degrees versus at 104 degrees, you literally have to have more oxidation at 104 than you do at 100, because the heat is dissipating your effectiveness of your sanitizer. And again, ORP will recognize that, especially through ICare. And PPM, a test strip, just can't do it. There's other monitoring devices that use PPM, and they don't have the same level of overall water quality knowledge as somebody using ORP. And that's the reason why commercial applications are, I mean, cities are strict on this.
Very.
And ORP is the most effective way of testing for a sanitizer or lack thereof a sanitizer.
So because I've had the question on the at ease quite a bit, because the part per million of chlorine on an at ease system is only 0.5 or higher of your free chlorine. So it works because you still have a sanitizer. You're just on the very low end of that sanitizer.
And a lot of that has to do with the fact that an at ease is utilizing silver. So anytime you incorporate silver into the water, whether that's through a silver mineral stick, the new soft skin spa now has silver in there.
Awesome.
Frog has silver in it. At ease has silver in it. So that's really what's allowing you to have a lower level of sanitizer. And it's just a number. So if you were looking at PPM and you wanted to have 0.5 to 1 part per million on at ease, on ORP, it's just a different number. Your range, and you get to customize this within the ICare. So the default is 650 to 750 on ORP. But if you were incorporating silver, ozone, UVC, some other alternative sanitizer or way of oxidizing the water, now your range can be from 500 to 750. No different than you would tell somebody 1 part per million to 5 parts per million. It's just a number. And you really don't have to worry about it, because the ICare has a color index. You just have to look at the color. Forget the number.
Yes.
The computer and all the software will worry about all the numbers. The color index is really what consumers look at. When it's blue, everything's great. When it's red, something's wrong. And the ICare kind of has a center sun to it, which is the overall water quality. And then it's got little planets around it. And those little planets can be a different color than the center sun. And you'll know exactly which thing is not quite right. You will also see arrows in those little planets that shows the way that it's trending. So is it trending up? Is it trending down? Is it trending even? So you can see those little planets. She's got three blues and one green. And the one green, if she's on, it just went dark. Yep. So she's really not that far off. Because she's utilizing silver, she's almost at 500. So she's, you know, what,
just,
30?
Just a little bit low.
35 points.
So if I go into, I go into recommendations, which is this little three lines right there. It's actually telling me not to do anything to that because it's literally right there. I mean, so if I wait three more days, and I'm guessing that sanitizers are going to pop right back up. So that's, I mean, it's not, even though it's showing that it's low, there is zero recommendations for me to do to that hot tub right now. So I just literally need to just enjoy it.
Yep. It's so minimal. And again, so many other chemical companies want you to go add more chemicals to the hot tub so they can go make more money. And so they're always trying to say, oh, go add 1/2 ounce, go add 1 ounce, go add 1.5 ounces. They're always trying to almost just get a little bit more for you to add to that hot tub. And I'm telling you, less is more when it comes to dealing with your water.
I'm sorry, that's funny coming from you. I've known Jim for a really, really long time. And his statement to me has always been, just one more hot tub, Jacque. That's all it's going to cost you is one more hot tub. Let's go back to the questions here. Kayla, so depending on the quality of the chemicals I add, will I be able to add chemicals fewer times than once a week, like every 2 weeks, or will I just add the amount like you were talking about with the pH down?
So you're going to add based on what it's going to recommend. For me to say that you're going to go one week or 2 weeks, I don't know your usage. I don't know the temperature. Those are all things that will come into play. So that's the great thing about the iCare is you don't have to think about it. When the iCare says, go do this, then that's when you go do it. If it happens to be once every week or once every 2 weeks or once every 4 days, and sometimes it might be every, one time it might be in 4 day increment. The next time it might be 2 days because there was more people that used it for a longer period of time. There's so many things that kind of come into play. And so there's no true answer to say, yes, you're going to be able to get longer, but what you will do or be able to do, because the fact that you're using better quality products, is you will be adding less of them. And again, when you can add less, you can turn around and minimize your TDS. TDS is the determining factor of when scientifically you should be draining and refilling your hot tub. Now, most companies will say, oh, drain and refill 3 to 4 times a year. Most consumers do it twice a year. But scientifically, if you're using chlorine or bromine or at ease, when you reach 2,000 parts per million of TDS, that's your indicator of draining and refilling your hot tub. Now, if you're on a saltwater hot tub, that you're going to go up to 3,300. So at 3,300 is the scientific measure for when you want to drain and refill your hot tub. And I know some manufacturers will say, well, you only have to do it once a year. That's not how the science works. So if you look at somebody using a small hot tub and they're using it a lot versus somebody that has a large hot tub not using it as often, their TDS levels are going to raise at two different rates. Somebody having a small hot tub that's using it all the time, their TDS is going to raise faster than somebody who has a large hot tub that's not using it as often. So it's all just based on the measurement, and the iCare will tell you exactly when to go drain and refill based on that TDS level.
Perfect. Because in draining, cleaning, and refilling is a big deal. So Tiffany, she's awesome. She does everything I tell her that she should do. But she says, my pH has been great since getting her iCare. My ORP is all over the place all the time. So is that, Tiffany, is that because you're looking at it all the time? Or is it just bouncing a lot? Because, I mean, I literally check mine probably once a week. I'm going to be real honest about it. I don't babysit it. I do, if I'm out of town, I watch it a little bit more because I'm more worried about the temperature, which is another cool feature of the ICare is that it'll let me know if the temperature drops. And if the temperature drops, I know I have a problem. But I don't babysit my ICare. I guess, Jim, you tell me what's...
So, first of all, she really needs to look at the overall average. But can you tell me a little bit more about her hot tub?
I forget where she's at. But she has a flare, I believe, either a flare or a flash. So saltwater hot tub, really hard water, super hard water. And we've had some issues with the salt cell scaling over a little bit and that type of thing. But, high pH, high alkalinity, everything that comes with that. But
okay. So a couple of things that she could do. One, the salt system that she has, it cycles differently than other salt systems. So let's say that she's got it set to run for 12 hours. That system does not run for 12 hours straight and then 12 hours off. It's actually every other hour. So if she's seeing on her ORP that literally it's every other hour, it's going up and down, up and down, up and down. That's just the cycle of how that salt system works. And when you look at, again, the overall average of how that kind of planes out, I would tell her to look at it on a weekly view. So instead of a daily view where you're seeing it go up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, look at it on a weekly view. And on the ICare, you can look at it on a day, week, or month view. And as long as she's averaging out, now, I don't know if she's utilizing silver, but if she's not utilizing silver, that's another thing that would help, whether she's using a silver stick or she's using the soft skin spa. The other thing that would help is if she, historically salt systems have high pH, which at that point you're almost having to overproduce on your salt system to compensate for the higher level of pH. So the more she can keep her pH in check, ideally 7.5, and that's one of the functionalities of soft skin spa, whether she decides to use that or she decides to use pH down, it's her choice. But the soft skin spa is just a weekly dosage and it will automatically lock in the pH and total alkalinity. So
she
her salt system
that, she not. Is using soft skin spa.
Okay, good. And what is her pH been maintaining?
She said after listening more, I address my pH immediately if it starts to creep up. So maybe that's why.
Okay. So anytime it creeps up, no different than looking at the oxidation of it, then the oxidation goes down when the pH goes up. So when she can maintain her pH, she'll have less bounce or going up and down with her sanitizer.
So, Tiffany, let me know, is that since you started using Soft Skin Spa, which I only think you've been on it a couple of weeks, so you may not have enough of it in there to stop that bounce yet. I believe she got hers on the Black Friday special, but she may not have enough Soft Skin Spa in there. But again, you may just be overwatching it. That could definitely be the case. Michael has been with us for quite a while too, and Michael Jensen says this ICare unit has been incredible and I would highly recommend it to Jackie's entire community. My water is currently in the blue status, great shape, pH is 700. Oh gosh, that's a long one. 700 MV, 101 degrees, and total dissolved solids at 1225. I believe he's a E system. I believe he is. Okay. So
yeah, it doesn't sound like a salt system because most salt systems are 1800 or higher from the start.
So, and then Tiffany says she's only used it twice, but I'm sure that she's talking about the soft skin spa there. So, but yeah, I mean, I guess that's the beauty of this ICare is that it takes everything into consideration. So if you just let it work and follow the directions, it's going to do it. You just don't want to overthink it and constantly. And that's, I've sold hundreds of these and a lot of people will come in and there is some tweaking to getting your settings just right. A lot of people, when they first get it, we have to readjust your settings to get your settings where they need to be. So depending on what, on the salt system or chlorine system, we need to adjust that. But once those settings are in line, and if you just let it work, like you said, your water will be perfect. So,
So can we actually touch on the settings and the customization of that?
I think everybody would absolutely love that if you would touch on that.
Okay. So when you go into the settings, you have really four main parameters that you can customize. The first one is going to be the temperature. Me personally, I keep my temperature range from 95 to 107. And people are like, well, why do you keep it at 107? Well, I keep my water at 104, 105. So when I'm looking at going at 107, the reason why I'm keeping it higher is because I don't want to get a nuisance notification. If the ICare device happens to float by the water that's coming directly off the heater, I don't want to get a nuisance notification. The reason why I keep it at 95 is that if it drops below 95, to Jackie's point earlier, there's something wrong with my hot tub. I've left the cover off, my breaker's tripped, I've got a dirty filter, you know, something's wrong with my hot tub. And then it turns around and it will give me a notification. The next thing is going to be your sanitizer. So your sanitizer range can be any. So Jacque, if you actually hit the double camera.
Yeah. Okay, when he says the double camera, he's talking about this middle thing here in the middle. So I'm gonna hit that.
And then there's a settings button up top, little gear. The whole screen will shrink and there's a little gear.
Is that what you want?
Yep. Yeah, and then go to target values. Okay, so we looked at the temperature at the beginning. So Jacque has hers, it looks like 98 to 104.
Yeah, this actually isn't mine. This is somebody in Georgia.
Oh, okay. And then you can see the pH is 7.1 to 7.7. The reason why it's set at 7.1 to 7.7 is because the ideal range is 7.2 to 7.6. So when it goes outside of 7.2 to 7.6, meaning 7.1 to 7.7, then I'm going to turn around and get a notification on exactly how much pH up or pH down to go add. The next one is the ORP. So if somebody is using silver, you can have from 500 to 750. If you're not utilizing silver, whether again, that's a Addy's system, a silver stick, or soft skin spa, then your ranges can be from 500 to 750. Now, not all mineral sticks are equal.
Not even
there's close. Ones now that don't even have any silver in them. They just call them a mineral stick and go, oh yeah, they're half of what I can get them for from my retailer, but they literally don't have any silver and they're not gonna do anything for you. So don't be fooled by the ones that are half the price. If they don't have silver, and there's two different forms of silver, I'm not going to bore you with the two different types of silver, but one is more effective than the other because it's a simpler molecule. And then the last setting that you're looking at.
This is a salt one.
Yeah, which is your TDS or your salt level. So if I was not running a salt system, I'm going to have it anywhere from, let's say, 250 to 2,000. And at 2,000, it's going to give me my indication to drain and refill. On a saltwater hot tub, Jackie's got, or this particular one's at 1,750 to 3,500. So at 3,500 is the indication of when to go drain and refill that hot tub. So that's how you're customizing those individual settings. And you can do that on your own. You can share a share code and it can be done remotely by somebody else.
Can I change somebody else's?
You technically can.
I didn't think I could, but I've never gone through that screen. I've always gone through if I go into here, I've always gone into this setting here. And then I'm assuming I can't change it there. But if I go into the setting that you just showed me, I'm sure I could change somebody's. And most, I'm going to be honest, guys, most of my customers actually do share that code with me so that I can adjust it. Or if, you know, they shoot me a text message and say, hey, what do I need to do? Water's cloudy or something crazy, which I've never had anybody with an ICare have a cloudy hot tub ever. Now, I've had them say it doesn't match my test strip, but I've never had them say I have a cloudy hot tub. So those are So I can take a look at it. And there are times, and this is going to kind of roll me into other situations or other questions that I get a lot, is you have on there, if you go into the back of the app, it'll tell you that we need to calibrate the sensors. So tell me more about that. Is that something that we need to do? Do we have to do it? I mean, I sell the calibration kits, but how big a deal is it?
So it's a good idea to calibrate once a year, just to bring them back to zero. So when you calibrate, let's say your ORP sanitizer was reading 10 points off. By recalibrating, it basically takes those 10 points and makes zero true again. Most people aren't doing it unless they see something go way out of whack. So they see one of the sensors that goes, man, I know my pH is not 5.0. Well, at that point, it probably needs to be recalibrated. There are a couple of things with some of the sensors that you might get an odd test every once in a while. Sometimes it's literally as having a little bubble underneath one of those sensors. And if you just tip the ICare on its side and get the bubbles out from underneath the sensors.
Oh, you mean when it's floating around, it'll just, yes. And if you just dip that over and get the air bubble out, really? That's new. Yep. So, and these are the sensors that he's talking about there, and they're super easy to change. I think I need that tool, right? I mean, I don't think I can just, there's a little tool that comes in the box, but you just literally put that on there, pop that out and change that. I have never had to, in my personal ones, I've never had to change a sensor. Let's talk about that a little bit. How often are those?
They really have not been much of an issue at all. The one that probably has more issues than any is the pH. And that's the blue one. So that one, again, you can either recalibrate it, replace it. In most cases, if you look at that pH one, it's got a clear glass to it.
I don't know if that's going to come up on camera.
But it doesn't really show up. But anyway, you can clean the bottom of those sensors. So if there's any film or something that gets on the bottom of the sensor, you can just wipe it off and you're getting a clearer view of the water when those things are clean. So it is a good idea just to clean it every once in a while.
So would you just clean that with like an eyeglass cloth or Windex?
A little sponge or something just to kind of get the film off there.
So awesome.
In most cases, that takes care of that weird reading that you get. We have replaced, I bet you, of the pH sensors, I bet you there's not even a dozen out of thousands that are out there.
Yeah,
it's so minimal.
It's so very, minimal. Very rare. And those are under warranty as well, correct? Those have a warranty?
Yes. So, that's underneath the 2-year warranty.
So
anytime that you're dealing with the sensors or recharging the battery, you would need to make sure that you take it out of the water. If you're going to recharge the battery, and this is all part of what's in the instructions, but just so people know what it is. So if you were going to go recharge the battery, you're going to take the ICare out of the water. You're going to pop the top with a little screwdriver that's provided, and you're going to let it sit for 12 hours.
That's important.
After 12 hours, then you can go ahead and plug it in. And it comes with its own charging port. But the reason why you want to pop the top, let it sit for 12 hours before you go plug it in, again, it's no different than your cell phone. This was just in a wet environment. And if you took your cell phone, had it in a wet environment, and all of a sudden went to go plug it in, you will affect the battery. So as long as you follow the directions, no issues. Same thing with the sensors. If for some reason you had to take the sensor out, just make sure you completely dry it off, let it sit for 12 hours, and then you can take the sensor out if you needed to.
So you're saying before you change the sensors, you need to let the sensors dry?
You need to let the whole ICare dry because those sensors are going directly up into the board.
Huh. See, I learned something today, guys. So that's a big deal. let's talk about, so I called you right before we got online here because my, I wanted to show on camera here what the things that we were talking about. And my, I had to charge mine this morning. So I pulled it out last night, let it dry, and then I charged it this morning. And I'm having a hard time getting it to connect to my Bluetooth. Now, explain to me why that is. Tell me what's going on there.
Yep. So the ICare itself, in the design of the product to conserve the battery, it does not put out a Bluetooth or Wi-Fi signal 24/7 like other devices. So if you really think about it, if you were to go, your cell phone puts out a Bluetooth and Wi-Fi signal all the time.
And you have to charge it every night.
You got to charge it every night. So with the ICare, the Bluetooth connection is not always going to be being put out, again, to conserve that battery. Same thing with the Wi-Fi. It doesn't have to put out a Wi-Fi signal 24/7. It's testing it every hour. It only needs to connect once an hour to be able to get that communication back to the app. So just because you don't see the Bluetooth connection doesn't mean that it's not working. It's just that sometimes you got to sit there and wait for that Bluetooth connection to happen between your phone and the ICare. And you do need to be within a couple feet of the ICare and your phone to be able to get that Bluetooth connection. But eventually it'll actually happen. And most of the time, Bluetooth connections are very rarely ever used. When you look at the app, there's an icon in the lower right-hand corner that looks like a little cell phone.
Mm-hmm.
Anything that is on that icon right there has to be Bluetooth connected. So the only, if you hit that, anything that's on that tab right now, it has to be Bluetooth connected.
Right. So if you don't have the Bluetooth connection, you're not really going to be able to see any of this other stuff. Now,
but
this has happened to me.
But most of the time, you're not having to do anything on that. So that's looking at your Wi-Fi signal, your battery. there's a second way of looking at your battery, your calibration. That tab really is used maybe once a year. That you actually need a Bluetooth connection.
I can say this is the second, maybe third time I've gotten into it. And two of the times I've called you because it was somebody else's ICare that I'm like, what's going on and why can't I fix this? And honestly, this is it. And I'm not going to lie, I let mine die. And so that's why I lost the connection, is I let it die. And I did charge it this morning and we will get it up and running again. But what you're telling me is I need to leave this by my phone until that Bluetooth is connected again. I don't want to go throw it out in the hot tub, and then unless I want to take the phone out to the hot tub with me, which I don't want to do.
Correct.
Because my hot tub's a no phone zone. Hopefully everybody else's is too. So, okay. So that was a good question I had. Warranty. We talked about ORP. Let's talk about alkalinity, and maybe we already did. That's probably the biggest and number one question that I get is, it doesn't measure alkalinity. Why doesn't it measure alkalinity?
Yeah. So even though there's not a sensor that says this is the alkalinity test, it's actually doing it through the software. So the functionality of having alkalinity in its ideal range is to not allow the pH to have bounce. So if the ICare notices that there is pH bounce, then it will recognize that the alkalinity is off and tell you to adjust accordingly. So when you look at alkalinity, most of the time having high alkalinity does not cause the bounce. It's low alkalinity that actually causes the bounce. So if somebody had, well water is a good example of this. Alkalinity is in the 300s.
Easy.
People are like, I got to add pH down. I got to pH down. Well, now I got to go add pH up. And how come it's the same product to lower it, but potentially two different products to raise it? And it becomes very confusing. So the only time that it's really going to give you an indication is when your alkalinity is technically low, it will tell you to add a pH increaser or an alkalinity increaser, depending on the manufacturer of whether using a bicarbonate or carbonate to raise the alkalinity or pH. So even though, again, there's not a specific sensor for it, it's looking at it from the software side of it to determine whether or not the alkalinity needs to be adjusted.
And so, and sometimes, and we live in South Dakota, Nebraska, that's where I you and I got to know each other, and we have super high alkalinity in those markets. And sometimes it will tell you to put a huge dose of pH decreaser in, like a huge dose. I have told people to do that in thirds. You know this unit better than I do. Is it something you just want to do the whole thing at once? You know, like I've seen 6, 7, 8 ounces of pH decreaser on, and I know it's a high alkalinity situation, so.
Yeah, I actually think it's a good idea to do it and split it up into smaller amounts. That way you're not over adding for any reason. And if for some reason, I've had people to where they told the system that they had a 500 gallon hot tub when in reality they had a 200 gallon hot
right.
tub.
I've and, seen that happen a lot.
Yeah. So by putting it in smaller increments, you are safeguarding yourself from situations like that.
Okay. So, and then we already asked, do you have to calibrate? So you are saying that people should buy a calibration kit when they get the unit.
It is a good idea to be able to do it. I wouldn't do it right when they buy the unit. I would wait until they need to use it because those calibration kits do expire.
So do you have that on your website? I don't have that on our website, and I do sell them, and I don't have that, but do you have that on your website?
So they're going to be on the website in Q1 of 22.
In quarter one. So I did put Jim's website up here. He's Ideal Water Care. And I'm sure I could put it on my website. We just haven't done it yet because I physically have them in stock. So if you want to get a hold of me, I can definitely, you can send us a message at the Hot Springs Plaza Sioux Falls, or you can get a hold of me on Instagram as always if you guys want to message me there. We just have to share some information, and once we do that, it's pretty simple, and I'll just get a calibration kit to you via that way. I'll probably just ask you for a phone number and give you a call, but nobody wants to put their stuff on the online where everybody in the world can see it, so we will get that up on our website. I've had them for, gosh, I bet I've had them for a year and a half. I just haven't sold a lot of them, so, but we will we will start telling people to do the calibration kit. I did have somebody text me a message that they couldn't get online to ask a question. They said, why the money? Is it worth it? Do you feel that it's worth getting the eye care? I mean, obviously you're going to say that, but,
To me, this is a very simple question after being in this industry for over 30 years. When you look at the number two reason why somebody doesn't buy a body of water, whether that's a hot tub, swim spa, or pool, the number two reason why they don't is their fear of how do I take care of this thing? And it's actually the number one reason they get rid of their body of water. So because they can't take care of it, they don't understand it, they're not chemists. So the very thing that they initially bought to enjoy, they don't enjoy anymore because they can't take care of it. When they don't take care of it, the water turns, you don't use it even less. And because you don't use it, you get rid of it. It's the number one reason why somebody gets rid of their body of water. And again, it's the number two reason why somebody doesn't even get it in the first place. The first one is just the overall cost of getting that initial body of water. So to me, when you look at the cost of this in relation to what you're trying to do with whether it's a hot tub or swim spa or pool, is it really isn't much money.
No, it really isn't. And I know when you first brought these to me and you're like, Jacque, you got to sell these. And I'm like, yeah, whatever. It's just another gadget. You have to earn your business with me, and you know that. But I was like, it's another gadget, and we were selling something else at the time. And at the time, that particular product really just tested the temperature of the water, and you could run the jets with the hot tub. I mean, you could actually control the control panel. But I mean, who cares if you can turn the jets on if you're away from the hot tub? And then I actually took one home, put it in my hot tub, and I'm like, Jim, this thing tests the water and tells you what to put in it. Why are we not promoting that? Because that is, it is the number one reason, like you said, that people, I just don't want to, I've heard the horror stories and I heard that it's a headache. And I mean, these have taken off like wildfire. Mm-hmm. In with maybe the exception of those snow melting mats, I do think that this is the best possible accessory you can get for your hot tub. Those snow melting mats are pretty cool. Have you got any yet?
Yeah, they are pretty cool. I keep seeing your post. We haven't had any snow here in Colorado.
Really?
So I haven't. Well, I should say where we live, but up in the mountains, there's still obviously snow.
Right. But yeah, the snow melting mats are pretty cool. However, this is probably a more practical and a more useful item to get for your hot tub. But these are awesome. And you're not going anywhere. ICare is in business. You're in for the long haul. And
for sure.
I mean, they're doing really well. And they've been around for actually quite a while. I mean, you're kind of new to the States, but they've been doing it. This isn't something
for over 5 years.
5 years. So
it's been over 5 years. Yeah.
And they've,
the other neat thing I like about it is the fact that it tells you what to do on a regular basis. It will remind you to clean your filter or filters. Mm-hmm. It will pull in local weather to remind you to lock down your spa cover when bad weather's coming in.
And that's a huge
deal. There's so many things that it does for you.
I mean, we had the tornadoes and the windstorms and everything come through the Midwest here. Was it Monday, Tuesday last week? Tuesday or Wednesday last week. I mean, and there were in Nebraska, because I was driving through Nebraska at the time, there were 120 mile hour winds clocked. And there were tornadoes that touched down, and it was crazy. And I wasn't home to be able to check my hot tub, but I was able to call Frank and say, hey, do this. And if you guys notice, I tried to get the word out as much as I could on my social media that, hey, lock your covers down, because that's a big deal right now, because you can't get a replacement cover. If your cover gets blown off, your hot tub's out of commission. There is no replacement covers out there. I know you're working on something there, and I'm excited to see how that works out. But there are no covers. And so it's more important than ever to take care of your cover as best as you can. And you've got this app now that tells you if it's remotely inclement weather, it's going to say, hey, buckle down your cover, or consider covering. I think it says consider covering your hot tub. It's so pleasant. It needs to say, get your tail out there and cover your hot tub, but lock it down. And that's a huge deal. So Kayla says, Jim can add that snow melting mat to the Christmas shopping he still needs to do. Amber would love that.
I know. Can I get that before Christmas?
I doubt it. In fact, I know not, because I ordered one for somebody and I'm not going to get it before Christmas. But there are some other vendors out there. I heard Heat Track. I think you can get those before Christmas. And those you can daisy chain. I know you asked me that question earlier, if you could daisy chain. The Heat Track ones you can daisy chain. So, and then they have real thin ones that you can put on your treads of your steps of your hot tub. Which is a big deal too. I just took home some really nice, they look really cool. They're made by Dreammaker, but they're a step that sits out in front of the hot tub, but it's a planter and a handrail, and it's really, really cool, but it's slippery. It is very slippery, and I'm getting old. So a good thing it's got a handrail on it. But yes, so I guess anything, we're coming up on top of the hour here. Anything you want to add, anything that we didn't talk about that's important on the iCares that you need to share with people?
So if I was going to end with this, it would be the fact that iCare will make the water more enjoyable, to where I believe you will turn around and use your hot tub more often, because you know that it's safe and healthy water.
It is. Yes. I agree with that 100%, because I don't even think about it. Remotely don't even think about it. So I am going to throw this in here. You are being gracious enough to give away an iCare. That's from you. iCare is the elf snowman there. He's kind of cute. So you're giving away an eye care. You can go to thehottublady.co, scroll down, and it's under the register to win a free eye care. That's prize number one. And then you're giving away Soft Skin Spa, too?
Soft Skin Spa also, yes.
So, and those are two awesome products. Doesn't cost you guys a thing to do that. Register to win that. The link for to do that is in the description in the show notes, but that's a big deal. That's huge. If you want to buy the eye care, you can definitely do that. Use the code, the link down below on that is, you can do it at Hot Spring Spa. Use the code HOTTUBLADY10 and you'll save 10% on that. If you shoot me a message, I might be able to get one out before Christmas yet, but you're going to have to reach out to me personally to make sure we get that happen. But otherwise, you'll probably see it next week sometime. But otherwise, you can get it from Jim as well. And that's his website is The Ideal Water Care. You got them in stock? Are you able to get them out?
I do. Yep. I ship daily.
He ships daily. So if you want it before Christmas, you may want to get it from him before me. I don't think he's got as cool a discount as I do, but
because
I'm special. But definitely check that out. And let's see, what did I have anything else I want to talk on? Oh, if you guys want, though, you can get the t-shirts yet. So let me pull those up. I think you can get those before Christmas. Let me scroll that up. But go to the t-shirts, and there are some cool Hot Tub Lady t-shirts here. But you can get those. Go to my website, thehottublady.co. And Jim, you get one of these for being a guest on my show. So pick out which one you want and let me know, and I will get that sent out, because there's about 9 different designs there. So check one out. The blue is amazing. You absolutely want to get the blue.
Okay.
So you would look good in the blue. So let me know. But you guys can definitely get one of those as well. That'll get your name on the front as well. You guys, as always, I think you are the absolute best. Make sure you shoot me a message on Instagram, at the Hot Tub Lady. I will answer any question there. Don't forget to subscribe, ring the bell, do all the things that help me help you become a happy hot tub owner. And that is definitely why I'm here. And Jim, thank you so very much for joining us today. Merry Christmas. Tell Amber Merry Christmas. Happy New Year. All that good stuff. And guys, thank you. And we totally appreciate you. And just remember, keep making life epic. Bye.
Bye. Thank you, Jack.